A very good afternoon and welcome to Sportswoman. My name is Becky Cynthia and I'm with Hope plus Faith Mirelle KI. We're going to talk about many things this afternoon. And I would like to inform you that we have Mary Nuba in the house. She's going to be taking us through what she's been doing during the lockdown. She's in the UK. Sportswoman goes everywhere. Last week, Faith was in South Africa. The other week, they were in Zimbabwe. So this is the only place you have to be every Thursday at 2:30 p.m. This is Cranes. She's a She Cranes goal shooter. And we will be here to discuss many things. We'll also talk about what is happening in the Uganda Premier League. There are a lot of things that are happening. Transfers, the FUFA president meeting the prime minister on when the league will resume. And we'll also take you internationally to talk about the English Premier League. Who is going where, who is staying where, and some of the people who were loaned want to go to their previous teams as first choices. A lot more this afternoon on the show. You can follow me on my Twitter, that is at Becky Cynthia N, and on Facebook, Nachmira Becky Cynthia. Welcome, Hope.
Thank you, Becky.
Yeah. Faith, hi. Do you remember Jackie Chandiru?
I know Jackie Chandiru. I don't have
you
to
don't
remember.
You don't have to remember. You look like her.
Okay, thanks.
The only difference is that you've forgotten your shades. I don't know why. The swag has, you know.
Spectacles, you mean?
Not spectacles. You had shades.
Spectacles.
No. Anyway, before we continue with the show, let's first speak to Mary. Mary, welcome on the show.
Very excited to join you guys.
Are you feeling the vibe?
I'm feeling the vibe.
Right. Hope, before you give us the highlight of the week, I saw the president earlier this week.
Last
week, he did 40 press-ups. So before we go on, can you just do two? I did 10 of them in the morning on Urban Today Sports. If you don't do them, for a commercial break. And I'm serious. We have to show these people that we are, you know, the strong women in sports.
Why are you strong?
A person who played basketball, how can you say that you're not strong?
The attire I'm wearing now can't allow me to do that. But I promise I will record and send.
Yeah, we are recording Tebi Kola now. Yeah. This is a live show. Things have to be done on set.
No, you can't ambush people like that. They have to prepare mentally for this.
Anyway, give us the highlight of your week.
Well, like you said, we have a lot to talk about. There's so much that has happened throughout the week. But I'm looking at Brian. He was moved to KCC as my highlight of the week. When they were interviewing him, he mentioned how it was so hard for him to leave Mbarara City. It was almost like his home. His home, actually. But I guess, like someone who wants to enhance his career and do better things, that was the best option he had at his disposal. So I wish him all the best, and I'd love to see him do an amazing job for KCCA next season.
And internationally?
Internationally, we had the Europa League last night, Manchester United winning, but far from their best. And I think that's why they need players like Jadon Sancho. Also a reinforce in different departments. But otherwise, also Inter Milan winning their game. To be honest, there's a lot happening over the week. I can't just, specify, what was my highlight.
Faith?
My highlight has got to be the FA Cup win by Arsenal. The rest take a back seat. Low light for sure has got to be the fact that there is a surge in these coronavirus cases, again, especially in the Western world, because I think the US Open is supposed to start in a couple of days or something, and some stars have pulled out because of it's not for them. They don't feel it's safe enough for them to go back and start playing. So that has got to be my low light.
And kudos to Taylor also, who helped Arsenal win the FA Cup. Anyway, Mary, we are back to you. Briefly tell us who Nuba is. Like, for the first time, as we were seeing you, they don't know who you are, who inspired you into this sport. Briefly tell us about yourself.
My name is John Mary Numa. 23 years old. Have studied sports science at the college, Loughborough University. Also played the national Ukraine, and also playing at the Loughborough Lightning Club Netball Club. Okay.
Who inspired you into the sport?
So back in 2013 is when I introduced Netball.
Did you only play netball, or there was another sport you were trying out? That's why you left basketball, because of the training and everything like that. Our colleague Faith here played basketball in high school, and she was the big man. Faith.
No. I still do.
Hey, you still play basketball?
Yes, I do.
Not
professionally.
Let me tell you something.
But in my compound.
In your Corporate league is one of the opportunities we have in the company. And it has people that are retired. We see goalkeepers who played in high school, and they are now casual people. Yeah. And we always see them play in corporate league. But I've never seen Faith step on the court.
No,
I'm always there, but
maybe
I've never seen
Faith. No, there's a reason.
She just has the love for the
sport.
There's
a reason why. Mm. I actually have no interest in playing corporate league basketball. Mm. I just started playing basketball again during this break.
Yeah,
but
because
I had no interest. Mm. But now that I know I still have the skill, I still have the, you know.
What number were you playing?
Me? Mm. You don't need to know. You have to watch.
Oh, no, yeah. You
have to watch
Mary.
Me.
What was netball?
You have to watch me.
What was playing netball like at high school level and at campus when you're still here in Uganda?
So it was really interesting. Quite much with my energy, because I was a bit lazy and didn't work as much now. I have a lot of energy. It was really fun and just exploring. We were young and we traveled to Kenya
Had you ever thought of going pro before this, when you were still here?
No, to be honest, no. I was already focused. I just came to college, high school. And I succeeded in it. I was also selected under 21 in 2015.
Mary, it's not been easy for you. Most of us will see you and imagine it has been easy. What would you say was the toughest experience in your life from when you started playing netball initially as a high school student?
Mary, I think we are losing her.
I think the connection lost, but we'll get back to Mary.
Yeah. Anyway, I do remember having a word with Mary.
She's back.
So 2018 is when I returned officially, and then appeared on African Cup, and that was it. I didn't need to go back. I was like, that is it.
I got the chance, need to use it, and never turn back again.
Well, Mary, I know your story is very inspiring, and just like Faith said, you know, it has not been a smooth ride for you. But transitioning from, the domestic league here, then playing in the UK, what are some of the challenges that you've faced as a young girl playing in England?
There are a lot of changes that occur from a different country, the Western world, everything, the culture, the way people do things here, and all professional.
Like, I was not a pro. Like, I would be late for training sometime, or some things I didn't think hard about it because I was not used to it. So there was a lot to add and a lot to take in and to learn. So that was one of the challenges, but I take it to be a positive one because it makes me a greater person now. Like now I can timekeep, I'm a very good timekeeper, which was one of my weaknesses, and speak frequently and just confident, and that skill I needed.
So when you went to the UK, I remember I was in a Zoom meeting with you a couple of weeks ago. You went to the UK and the one thing you were saying is there are so many things they have to reteach you and things you learn. You have to learn afresh sometimes, not because you're not good enough, but maybe because you didn't learn them properly. During this period of COVID, what would you say you've worked on specifically? Because the Vitality Super League is cancelled until 2020, so you're literally off. You've been off for close to 9 months. You're going to be off for 9 months. So what are you working on right now?
Right now, what we are working on as a team, not even on the video, is to just keep fit, just keep your body, your muscles still engaged. That is to go for a run or go for a bike. Your task is to complete about 20 kilometers a week. That is enough for your body to keep fit and still return to sport. So we are not doing much in particular because we are not returning to sport until further notice. But we will start our pre-season, hopefully in September, no, December. But December, Jan, yeah, about there. And we will not sit until then. We have to be keeping engaging into the netball, not netball necessary, but to keep fit. That is to go to the gym, to go for a run, to do core work, and to keep your muscles engaged.
Mary, we understand that a culture depicts sports differently, especially when girls involve in them. We understand in netball, there is that kind of attire that you people wear. It's short. Haven't you gotten any criticism? Your side, like your home area, that our girl is, you know, exposing, indecent, she's exposing her body, haven't you?
No. I would relate to it maybe back in high school. Yeah, but we used to train in short skirts and short is when we were a little bit like criticized and were advised to wear like sports leggings. But now it is a professional thing, and I don't think about it much because it has been there for ages. And who are you to judge me? Because netball is netball. Not what I found. I'm just wearing what people are wearing, you know? But in my personal life, I don't think about too much about what people say because that just pins you back and just pulls you backward. But you just makes you happy. But game-wise, it's netball. That's the art. So I wouldn't wear a long skirt because people think it is short. That is just the game.
Okay. Actually, Becky, for me, when you talk about such things, I just find it strange for me. Especially when someone is playing sports, like if the most you have to talk about in a situation where I'm playing is how short the outfit is. Instead because the one thing we do have to admit is when you're like locked in and you're thinking and the adrenaline is pumping in your body while playing sports, the list of your worries
is about the attire.
Where your skirt has gone. You might come back and you see these photos.
The player won't mind it, but you know what people always talk about. I remember, most people that work here, I'll give you an example, they don't follow netball so much. So when Uganda was playing South Africa, that is when people noticed who Noba was. And you know what people used to comment about was the dress code. Look at that chick, she's very tall. You know, those are the compliments that people could give. So for the elders, you never know what, you know, they talk about. So it is also important to know if she has ever gotten criticism.
I think, Beck, it also comes down to the lack of understanding of the sport. When people don't know what netball is all about, they will not understand some of the things that are done. So you cannot blame them unless people are educated and, you know, they get some bit of knowledge about,
Being educated.
No, but Becky, I feel like some sports, naturally, you just have to breathe, be able to breathe.
Because if you mind about that, you can never, you know, perform on the pitch or on the court.
Okay.
So that to answer that in the correct manner is just about feminism. I don't know, that word disturbs me, but to do with femaleism. But if we look at how men dress, it's totally different from the way women dress. In order to attract a lot of attention, women had to dress in an exposing way, which I read about in the media in the course that I'm taking. But that's how it has been in ages, and we can't change it now. What we can change is the mindset of people, what they think when they are supporting girls' sport or women's sport. They shouldn't go for how they look, but to the game itself, which other people, unfortunately, they go to the other way around, how people are dressing. Like, we are identifying like how short our dresses are, and that shouldn't be the case at all. It's quite heartbreaking that people really look at that factor to be defining as netball, which is really sad.
Okay, I heard you speak of Peace Proskovia at the start. Has she been a strong element in your growth?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. So I talked about 2018. It's when I participated in the international team in Zambia. And during this period, I observed a lot of things secretly from Pete. That is, she came in time. She was doing her other workouts that would help her build. And I would always ask, be so conscious of, why is she doing that? Why is she doing squat? Why is she doing this? And somehow she would open up and tell me, this is how people behave when you play in the pro game. You have to come in time, you have to be disciplined, you have to be passionate. And I was like, God, I have a lot of elements that are missing. And I was like, I need to catch up with you, please. And she would have just a chat with me about how she was, she got up and she didn't stop moving because she faced a lot of challenges. But those challenges gave her a reason to move forward and to become who she is right now. So I noticed that I had problems myself, my career, my personal life. And I was like, could you tell me something that will build me? And she often did that.
Mary, I know, you know, it's not always easy for a female personality to make it, especially in a male-dominated industry. You know, what are some of the things that need to be done, you know, to see that women find their rightful place in this industry?
So in the sport industry, there's nothing much we can do, unfortunately, but to just create awareness to all the girls out there, and to also the guys in charge, please. We are here not to compete with whatever you think that we are taking over the sport and all that. We are here also to explore our talent, also to take on our talent and to be successful as much as men are doing in sport. But we are kind of late down when we come to expression in Uganda and also other who say the whole world, when it comes to women who or girls for is normally not advertised or taken serious because of the nature of how women are. They're considered weak and not be able to deal with a lot of problems that come through a game that is like, for example, rugby. They assume that a woman can't really tackle that hard than a man and is rough and all that. But to come out from that thinking, women should have that strong resilience to do whatever they think they can do in their power. I can't play netball, I can't play football, but there are some advantages that I have, me playing netball, and there's something I learned from that what matters most.
Mary, do you think the government has done enough to fund netball as a sport in Uganda?
No, really no. And I think we have a journey, we still have a journey to really look into sport. To take, for example, netball, we have participated in a lot of international games, including World Cup. A lot of appearances at African Cup, and we have had titles, even a trophy in 2018, and nobody has acknowledged that, and that is quite not fair for us to put in all that energy, and nobody really sees our efforts and really appreciates us. Appreciate it is not just speaking, do something about it. There are so many players who are injured, even now, for example, Badia, she's injured. When she played in the World Cup, she can't return back to sport. Simply, she can't get the treatment that she needs, but she's a very good player. But she will be forced to retire like she is now because we don't have an upper hand to help ourselves or to be heard. We have been promised and promised, but nothing has been done. That sounds really unfair, especially when we are doing that much to the country. We are raising the flag to the country, six in the world, that is a title. And it's something we hand with a lot of hard work, focus, and we have sacrificed a lot for it.
Just one second before we say bye to you, Faith. Yeah. Any question in 1 second? And hope.
What do you think we can do to change that status quo?
What I think we can do is for the government also to look into it, to look into deep things. Not just things don't seem the way they are. We look happy, yeah, but there are so lot of things that hinder us, especially from tax feeding. Would have a lot of pro girls because we have a lot of girls that have a lot of energy and experience. But there are so many things that we don't do as a nation or as it in the team, like the training we have, would hinder us from progressing.
Do you think the Federation has not done enough?
I think Hope, Mary will answer that next time. I guess this is not the first time or the last time we are going to be seeing our own Sportswoman. And thank you for that invite, for taking us to Loughborough Lightning. It's been amazing. I think next week our producer will take us to the US. Who knows? Thank you so much, Mary. Until next time, we'll go for a short commercial break and we'll be back.
The producer is tired.